If you do not understand the role and impact of switching frequency and duty cycle in the field of power electronics, then understanding and developing any power electronic converter will be very difficult for any engineer. This is because the concepts of switching frequency and duty cycle forms the backbone of any power electronic converter. Watch this tutorial till the end and we will understand how an increased switching frequency gives the necessary edge to power electronics when compared to the field of conventional electronics. Let us understand the impact of switching frequency in power electronics with the help of STM32F4 discovery board. This is a development board which is based on a microcontroller, and this microcontroller has various modules in it like GPIOs, timers and other communication based modules as well. For our understanding, we will limit our discussion only to general purpose output module. Let us look at the circuit that we have already used in the previous tutorial. As you can see, using this circuit, we have energized a DC lamp load using a DC voltage source via a series switch in between. We have already seen that if we turn this switch on and off thousands of times every second, then this DC lamp load will be perceived as glowing rather than it being turning on and off. Let us try to understand this example with a practical demonstration using the STM32F4 discovery board. Before that, let us replace this mechanical switch with an electronic switch which will be turned on and off with a suitable voltage level. The only difference between the mechanical switch and the electronic switch is that the mechanical switch can be turned on and off by closing and opening of a mechanical link, whereas if you want to turn on the electronic switch, you will have to give a sufficiently high DC voltage to the gate of the MOSFET, and if the gate of the voltage is brought down to the zero voltage level or ground level, then the electronic switch will be turned off. In the on state, the electronic switch will allow power to flow from the DC voltage source to the lamp load, and in the off state, the electronic switch will inhibit the flow of power from the DC voltage source to the lamp load. This is the circuit that is implemented on the STM32F4 discovery board. Let us check that circuit. In the circuit of general purpose input output port of STM32F4 discovery board, this much section is used when this port is configured in input mode. So we will not consider this portion as of now. This section is the general block diagram for the general purpose input output port when it is programmed in output mode. The left hand side has a DC voltage source embedded in the discovery board, and any other peripheral can be connected in the right hand side of this module. The turning on and off of this switch will allow or inhibit the power from the source to the load connected on this side. On the STM32F4 discovery board, LEDs are connected on the port PD12, PD13, PD14 and PD15. These are connected in this manner. When the switch is turned on, these LEDs will glow because the current from the DC voltage source will be flowing via this current limiting resistor to the LED. Let us write a code in the microcontroller which will allow the LED to blink but with a very low frequency, so that the LED will be seen as turning on and off easily. As it can be seen from the blinking of the LED is turned on and off every second. The LED is remaining on for 0.5 seconds and it is remaining off for 0.5 seconds, which means that the switching frequency for the LED switching is 1 second. This is because one complete cycle, which constitutes the turning on and turning off of the LED, is taking 1 second to get completed, and this cycle is continuing. Now let us double the switching frequency of this LED such that it will remain on for 0.25 seconds and after that it will remain off for next 0.25 seconds. Which means that the complete cycle where the LED will turn on and off will take 0.5 seconds to get completed. Let us consider a switching cycle where the LED will remain on and after that it will remain off for equal amount of time. And this cycle of switching will continue till infinity. The cycle of switching is such that the frequency of switching is 1 Hz. The frequency of any cyclical or periodic phenomenon is nothing but the number of times this periodic phenomenon is repeating itself per second. Our cyclical phenomenon of turning on and turning off of the LED is taking 1 complete second to get over, which means that our frequency of switching is nothing but 1 Hz. In simpler terms, it means that our cycle of turning on and turning off of LED is taking place 1 cycle per second. If we make our frequency from 1 Hz to 2 Hz, then it will mean that 2 cycles of this periodic phenomenon will get over per second. Hence, graphically we can see that that one cycle will get completed every 0.5 seconds and hence the LED will remain on for 0.25 seconds, after which it will remain off for 0.25 seconds. And this cycle will keep on repeating itself. Let us double the frequency of this switching and observe the blinking of the LED on the discovery board. As we can see, the speed of the blinking has increased as compared to the previous state. But still, one can easily distinguish between the turning on and turning off of the LED. Now we will increase the switching frequency to 1 kHz, that is 1000 Hz. And in simpler terms, it means that our LED will turn on and off 1000 times every second, which means that a complete cycle where the LED will turn on and off will take 1 millisecond to get completed. And it can also be said that the LED will remain on for 0.5 millisecond, after which it will remain off for 0.5 milliseconds. And this cycle will continue itself. Let us write this code for STM32 microcontroller and observe the blinking of LED. Now, as it can be seen, the switching cycles of 1000 cycles per second is very high, such that it is impossible to be detected by human eye. Hence, we can say that if the switching frequency of this LED is in terms of kilohertz, then human eye won't be able to distinguish between the on state and off state of this LED. This is where the tool of duty cycle comes into play. By varying the duty cycle of the electronic switch which is kept in between the source and the load, one can control the delivery of power from source to the load. But you might ask, what is the reason of increasing the switching frequency of the MOSFET to such an high extent? The answer to this question is the size of electronics, or one can say the size of magnetics to be specific. The size of magnetics is proportional to the switching frequency. For the AC voltage that is supplied to our household, the signal frequency is about 50 or 60 Hz, which means that only 50 or 60 cycles are completed every second. Whereas in power electronics, thousands or even sometimes millions of cycles are completed every second. Due to this drastic increase in the switching frequency, one can have a drastic decrease in the size of magnetics. This advantage can be clearly observed in these pictures. The picture on the left hand side is of a transformer, or one can say it is a conventional transformer which is used in electrical power supplies, rated at 12 watt. And the same power supply, if it is produced using power electronic switches, then it will require the transformer which is placed on the right hand side. One can clearly see the difference in size of both these transformers. A smaller transformer which is used in power electronics will have very less cost as compared to the transformer used in conventional electrical power supplies. Also, due to this reduced size, the overall dimensions of the power supply when made using power electronics will also be very less. But the major advantage is that by varying the duty cycle of the electronic switch, we can control the power delivery to the load. We will see this concept of duty cycle in the upcoming tutorials. Hence, we can say that an increased switching speed for the electronic switches in terms of kilohertz or megahertz gives the necessary edge to the power electronic converters when compared to conventional electrical converters. Watch this playlist for step-by-step understanding and design of flyback converter.